the other four losses by a total of 10 points. The starting lineups, Jabari Bouye averaging 20 points per in league action. Big change for BYU. Gideon George starts for the first time since late November. BYU all time is 13-3 when he starts, including the other four losses by a total of 10 points. The starting lineups, Jabari Bouye averaging 20 points per in league action. Big change for BYU. Gideon George starts for the first time since late November. BYU all-time is 13-3 when he starts.
He inserted Gideon, and the reason he did that is he rebounded well in their loss to Pacific. They've lost two games, their last two games, by a total of 4 points. So it's not like they've got to recreate the whole deal, right? But he's a perfectionist. So they're working at it. They are 10-0 in this building.
It's the first time they've lost back-to-back regular season games under Pope, and there's George who gets a touch early. Fighting in the lane, a kick to Nell. Ball screen denied. Both teams shoot the three. Both teams defend the three. Lucas. The runner off and the rebound of the size of Yawen Masalski, who's been a double-double machine.
Seven on the year. He's 6'9", 240. Tapay, the other post player, is 6'10", 245. They have a size advantage, and you can see it right here. Look at the difference in size here.
And it's Tapay right against Gideon George. That's something that Mark Pope told us stood out to him as soon as he hit the floor for the first matchup. The size and length of San Francisco.
Well, Tapay had 12 in that game in San Francisco. Welcome to Provo, says Alex Barcelo. This guy is a killer. One of my favorite college players the last 3 years.
Tapay. Gabe Stefanini playing catch. Tapay hoists it up, rattles down.
I really admire Todd Golden, what he's doing right here. He realizes Tapay played well the last time they played. They know that they have a size advantage, and he goes right to it.
And Barcelo slithers back door, and the big fella, Fuseni Traore, finds him.
I love the way you say Traore. Little weave action up top. Stefanini taking it hard to the goal.
Stefanini on high, hits heel. And missed threes were an Achilles heel for San Francisco in the first matchup. 3 for 23. Barcelo does not miss.
Are you kidding me? I chatted with him before the game. He made 7 of 7 last year in this game in Provo. 7 of 7 threes last year.
Set the program single game record. Missed point blank for Masalski, but he wins it right back. His guards want it. Bouye, he's not shy. Tapay, the one-handed board, can't handle.
This is going to be fast-paced.
And a foul on the drive.
Alex Barcelo is a player, there's no doubt about that. There is a sense of urgency to him. When you overplay him, he goes back door. If you play off him, he drills the three from deep. 2 for 2 from downtown already for Alex.
And a sub here, you see number 33, Caleb Lohner, coming off the bench for the first time since January of last year.
Last year he averaged 7 and 7. This year he's averaging 6 and 6.
Lucas leaning and sinking.
Mark Pope told us today that they lack their sense of urgency against Pacific. I see some urgency out here right now.
It's a 7-0 surge for BYU. On the bounce, Stefanini just corralled it and gives it right to Traore.
Traore is only 6'6", but he weighs 254, number 45. He uses the girth to work inside, but he's given away about 4 or 5 inches to Masalski in this game. Right here, let's see.
Masalski knocks it free, won by Shabazz. Pull up at the free throw line, off. Tapay's got it. Bouye, another deep three, and another miss. Loner wins it. And out of bounds, it'll be San Francisco ball.
Maybe that's why Loner's not starting right there. A little mental error. Bouye 0 for 2 from deep so far in this game. Shabazz, number zero right there. Shabazz is the guy they need to catch and launch. All-conference player you're looking at right there. He's got speed to burn.
Masalski rejected away by the subbed in Atiki Ali Atiki. Barcelo harassed up the sideline. A fury into the lane. Atiki Baker.
Wow. This place is going crazy.
No timeout here.
Sometimes you let guys play through it. It makes them mature better. Early in the game.
Another four shot, BYU ball on a 9-0 run. Loner on the cut. In and out. Bouye and Barcelo fouls him.
BYU is rocking and rolling in Provo. Barcelo got him off to a great start. Right here. And offensive rebounding for the Dons is a necessity. They started by going to Patrick Tappe early. He scored twice in a row. And since then, they've got zero buckets.
They are 0 for their last 8, including 5 attempts from 3. And there's another 3. It's an air ball for Richwing.
3 for 23 the last time they played the Cougars. 0 for 6 here.
Meanwhile, BYU, Seneca Knight. Atiki, Barcelo's been the hot hand. Gets a stride on Shabazz. Picks up the pound, top spot, and is shot short. Foul in pursuit of a loose ball. They'll get Loner with his first.
BYU's lack of size comes from injuries. Gavin Baxter early, Richard Harward, 6'11", Baxter 6'9", out for the year. Backdoor cut here.
Josh Koonin, another three-point try. Are these good shots?
Yes, they really are good shots, and I think they're a little bit in shock right now with the enthusiasm and great play of BYU. They take a ton of shots from three. San Francisco has taken 200 more threes than their opponents this year.
They're 0 for 7 to begin tonight. And Knight misses, hits heel, out of bounds. BYU ball.
I am impressed with Atiki and Gideon George. Those guys getting minutes right here, and they are taking advantage of it. Frequent substitutions by Mark Pope right now, looking for the right combinations.
Barcelo subs out for BYU. Do you like that?
No, if I had him, he'd play 40 minutes a game.
Tijon Lucas with the up fake. Hard harm arrives. Bouye trying to defend.
Yeah, I think the thing with Barcelo right here is we take a look at Lucas. See, Barcelo has one foul, and they're playing with great intensity right here. And I think Mark Pope is thinking, get him out here, get his legs ready, you know, and then get him back in. They've got a lead right now. Spencer Johnson in number 20, right there with the basketball.
And Lucas gets hit. It was Tijon Lucas, along with Barcelo, that led a players-only meeting with select teammates at Barcelo's apartment on Sunday. Defensive communication seemed to be the biggest issue in the two losses.
Yeah, and they weren't identifying guys on the break, number one. And number two, which was really the most dramatic thing, drives to the basket. There was no help side. Pacific got a ton of easy shots at the rim. Speaking of at the rim, that was barely grazed. I don't think that hit the rim by Lucas. That is odd.
And remember, Lucas just got hammered by Bouye. I hope he's okay.
2 years at Illinois, one at Milwaukee. And he's here at BYU playing great.
Much better ball movement from the Dons here. Stefanini twirling. Up fakes, don't Duke Lucas. Up and under, and help! Atiki, one underneath, and finished by Masolsky.
Well, Masolsky's got to get on the offensive glass. There's no doubt about that. That's one of the keys for San Francisco in this game. His man went to help, and he got in the right spot.
Dons had missed their prior 11 shots, hadn't scored in over 5 minutes. Johnson falling away. Misses, goes after it. Hits bottom backboard, Dons ball.
Both coaches are substituting frequently. Look at this block. And he's in the right place at the right time. This is an intelligent, athletic, IQ guy who transferred here from San Diego within the conference. And they are really, really happy to have him.
Alex Barcelo is back, defending at the top of the key.
Zane Meeks, number 5 in the game, 6'9", outside shooter. Tappe, 2 for 2, hasn't touched it since.
Here's Meeks lying in wait, hits the iron. The Dons are 0 for 8 from deep.
They're going to keep shooting them, there's no doubt about that. 3 of 23 the last time they played, and they were 24 of 28 from the free throw line. So Todd Golden believes in the three.
And there's the first make. You know, Todd Golden said he thought it helped his team to be down last time out against Santa Clara. He said they were up 20 first half against St. Mary's, and it was hard to maintain that focus. And he thought his team loosened and played better when they felt a nearly double-digit deficit. Barcelo is helping that cause.
Well, I'm not so sure about feeling that way, but if he said it, I believe it. There's a sense of urgency sometimes when you're behind that you don't have when you're ahead.
Rich Wayne, flat shot. Barcelo has outscored the Dons by himself. He's got 10. George surveys. Bounces out tonight. Barcelo lurking in the left wing. Gets
nice,
fed.
Nice ball movement.
And a travel. And Barcelo just snapped, turning around, looking at Bouye.
Alex Barcelo, Mr. Todd Golden was a player at St. Mary's in this league. Terrific assist to turnover guy. He has a connection to Bruce Pearl, was an assistant at Auburn. They talk frequently.
Bouye, Barcelo fell down, point blank.
Bouye's got speed, man. He can take it on the dribble. That's a tough, tough assignment for Barcelo.
Barcelo on high. A miss, and Rich Wayne's got it. The BYU lead once sat at 8. Here come the Dons, a chance to tie.
Get the ball inside on the dribble or the pass.
Rich Wayne nearly had his pocket picked. Stefanini falling away. Tough shot.
Well, he sensed Barcelo's lack of height. Took him into the paint. Nice little turnaround from the product from Italy.
Barcelo seeing length all around.
They want to trap him now. Teams have done that in the league. Make him give the ball up.
George down the lane. Good up fake and late on help. Tappe. And Meeks were there. Meeks will be charged with a foul, his first.
Nice rotation by Golden with the three post players. With Wasowski out, he still has Tappe and Meeks in the game, so he continues to have good size. There's his record the last 3 years. One of the hot young coaches in America. I'll tell you what, Coach Pope is rotating players like a revolving door at Macy's during the Christmas holidays.
BYU is 0 for 4 at the line. They're a top 3 free throw shooting team in the West Coast Conference.
Yeah, but that's because Lucas and Barcelo take most of them.
Bouye. That was altered by the length of Atiki.
Nice rim protection right there by Atiki.
Rich Wayne the steal.
Too much by George. That's not his game.
Meeks awkwardly stumbles and grabs it.
Those were four passes that were all almost turnovers. Still plenty of time on the clock.
Bouye off BYU. Atiki.
Atiki's doing a good job on the boards. He's 6'9 now. Only a freshman.
Atiki.
They're finding something with this kid. 6'9. Tanzania. Played good in the last game.
Bouye's first make from deep.
Conspicuously absent from the scoring for the Dons is Khalil Shabazz on the bench right now.
He's only played 6 minutes. George. And a rebound to Bouye.
Wow. You got to be brave to take that charge. He was going about 100 miles an hour. Bouye on the run smacks right into Nell. Woo! Two fouls. Is that serious? Bouye is going to have to sit the whole half.
Now and one.
Nell nailed it. Terrific athlete, this guy. Strong and fast.
Another free throw miss, 0 for 5, BYU.
Very, very interesting and unusual. The last time they played, BYU was 14 of 18 from the free throw line.
All in the second half, and no attempts in the entire first half.
Yep.
Oh, Masalski with the feed, and Richwayne didn't see it coming.
Oh,
they're
going to
say Don's ball.
Oh, I think that was off Richwayne's knee.
And the replay just played on the big board. You can hear the crowd's thoughts.
Yeah. The officials almost get it right almost every time. We'll give them a break on this one.
Masalski showing the range with one on the timer.
That's not much of his game. But I'll tell you what, when he's close to the basket, he is deadly. BYU's doing a great job on interior defense and protecting the rim in this game.
Nell, quick release. Rim glass, a miss, out of bounds. Don's ball.
BYU starting to take some shots that are not high percentage. Mark Pope doesn't like it. Immediately in the game, kind of shocked USF a little bit. And then they gathered themselves because they're a very experienced team. A lot of older players on both of these squads and in this league, frankly. And it has added to the fact that they have four teams, maybe five, in contention for bids.
Lucas spinning in the paint, surrounded by gold. Barcelo from the free throw line. Alex Barcelo with a dozen.
That is a difficult shot that he has mastered. Most guys hit front or back rim on that shot, floating forward. He's worked on it. He's accomplished.
Bouye, another deep three.
Well, you were asking me about threes. Should they change what they do? And they don't. They're going to take a bunch of threes. Last time they played, they took 23. I'm suspecting they're going to go north of 30 in this game.
Barcelo has a big, and Meeks bounce to George. Hesitant triple. In and out.
Not his game. Barcelo needs help scoring, and Lucas is the guy that needs to step up.
Stefanini trying to come to the ball. Nell all over him. One-handed bounce to Meeks. One-on-one against George. Trying to muscle him. Rolls off the iron. Traore's got it.
Nice step out there.
George misses. Traore put back. No. Meeks got it.
That's the size advantage right there that the Dons have. That play right there epitomizes where BYU is. Small post players.
Meeks, George knocked it away. It's Dons ball, 15 to shoot. 29-21, the Dons on the road, trying to upset a BYU team unblemished at home.
Scheduling, my friend. Got to get a lot of those neutral site games. Play some home games, get a few postponed. Much more balanced scoring right now for the Dons. Barcelo is carrying it with 12 points. Atiki has 4. Nobody else has more than that for BYU. And they cannot continue that way. They've got to get scoring help from other guys.
Three to shoot. Bouye at the horn. Hits iron. Meeks wins it in heavy traffic. Pepe twisting and missing. Loose on the deck. And it's won by BYU, and Lucas snaps it up ahead to Lohner. Knight begging for it on the trail, and instead Bouye has the loose ball.
See, that's a situation where Lohner is going on a situation like that, and you give up 5 points, really. I mean, he turns it over when they had a break situation by trying to do too much. BYU needs to move the ball more. Get deeper into the shot clock. Make the Dons work defensively more and get clean looks.
Shabazz off iron. That's the first miss in a while for the Dons. They began the game 1-for-11 from deep. They had hit 5 in a row before that misfire.
We got some tired guys out there right now.
Air ball. Bouye.
He wants to push it. If he sees a seam, he's going.
Meek steps into it and misses. Barcelo weak side. Seneca Knight, aggressive drive and a foul going right at Tepe. That'll be his second.
The Dons doing it. Masalski, mid-range jumper. The ball movement on the break. Shabazz knocking in threes all over. That is a tough one.
So 2 fouls on Tepe. Bouye's been playing for some time with 2 fouls. Rare free throw make for BYU, and a slew of subs here for USF. What are your thoughts on Bouye being out there with 2 fouls?
I think it's his experience, and I think Todd Golden says, you know what, we need. He went out with 2 at 8:48, and I thought he wasn't going to come back, but they needed him. They were down at the point, and putting him back in was key to this run. Even though Shabazz is making all the shots, this guy is running the show. So it was a calculated gamble that worked out perfectly for Golden.
Shabazz defended by Barcelo. Ball screen to Masalski.
ISO. You can forget about that one. I mean, you're talking about a guy who has played lots and lots and lots of games against a novice player.
Oh.
And a foul down low off ball.
Check this out right here. This is an isolation play. He's got it in the paint. There's really no chance right here.
It's just about automatic. And Masalski gets called out. Coming this March, catch the Missouri Valley Conference semifinals on CBS Sports Network March 5th, followed by the championship game on CBS March 6th. Get ready for Arch Madness, the Missouri Valley Conference tournament presented by State Farm.
That's a great one. Loyola Chicago doing it in that league again in their last year before they moved to the A-10.
Bouye wave it off, hit on the floor. Todd Golden upset. He wanted continuation.
Bouye's got that stoic approach, doesn't he? I mean, his facial expression doesn't change much during games, whether things are going his way or not going his way. And that's what you want from a player with that kind of personality.
Foul to Spencer Johnson, his second. Stefanini, three ball.
Plenty of guys making and taking threes now for San Francisco.
Cougars facing their largest deficit. Haven't hit a field goal in 4.5 minutes. Bouye, that's two fouls on Barcelo.
Speed personified. Barcelo used the forearm on him. That's going to be an automatic call. You don't want to risk a third for him in the closing moments of this half.
Entry anticipated. Johnson tumbling on the deck.
Johnson just saved a layup for his team. That was a nicely executed play, and he dove in there and knocked it away. What you want.
What do you want to see here?
Well, you know, things are going well the way they're going. So you want this guy with the ball down the stretch here.
Stefanini begging for the ball. Deep three. No. Aggressively won by Atiki, and that's a foul on Tepe. So he's got two.
Todd Golden's got multiple players who can look like both guys were just going for the ball there.
It is double bonus. Another free throw miss. BYU is 5 of 12 at the line.
Ooh. We're seeing some experience versus inexperience in this game, especially in the post area. Tappe, Columbia, and Duke, fifth-year guy. Same thing with Masalski. Very, very experienced players. 37-25 because of it. Mark Pope's got to get it in the West Coast Conference.
Bouye with 8. Shabazz has 11. Don's at the ball. About a 6-second differential here out of the use it or lose it.
I think when you're this far ahead, you just go ahead and play. They're going to try to run it down and take the last shot, not give BYU any chance at anything. Problem with that is it's 5 seconds differential.
Three to shoot. Bouye needs to shoot from near midcourt, and he hits it! And BYU doesn't realize the time. It expires before Lucas's heave. What a shot by Jamori Bouye as the Dons hold BYU without a field goal for the last 5.5 minutes.
The interior for San Francisco has been excellent, and the smaller post players for BYU are having a difficult time scoring in the paint.
Outside of Barcelo, the rest of the team combined for 11 points on 4 of 16 shooting from the field, 0 for 3 from 3, and 3 for 11 from the line.
Yeah, and you're going to lose by 30 if that happens in the second half again. Got to give credit to the Dons. Their defense was terrific.
Masalski gets it to go.
Interesting, they started the game by going inside to Tappe. He delivered 2 for 2, and they start the second half the same way, going inside. See, this is a problem right here.
Bouye in transition.
I tell you, you may be called timeout right away on this, because that's the second time a post player has put the ball and poked it away from the offensive player because the offensive player is holding it too close to the D.
George rejected hard by Tappe. Bouye Euro down the lane. And Traore wraps it around to Lucas, who's been eerily quiet. George made the start tonight, and he has his pocket picked. Able to return the favor. Sprawl on the deck. Stefanini's got it.
Officials don't call timeouts or fouls early on those kind of plays anymore.
Shabazz. Oh, he shook Barcelo, and he sticks the elbow J.
You've got to get a timeout. It's just, they're shell-shocked. If they keep playing the way they're playing, they're going to have a great shot at being in the NCAA tournament and may have a great shot of challenging Gonzaga in the West Coast Conference tournament. Todd Golden's done a great job of getting guys thinking straight and all on the same page.
Out of BYU's call timeout, Barcelo, his first points of the second. BYU went 7-plus minutes without a field goal make, bridging the two halves.
Lucas has to get going, number 3 for BYU. He's their second leading scorer. He's working hard at the defensive end. But he's got, when he penetrates into the lane, he's got to make something happen more than he did in the first half.
Masalski fouled by Lohner, his second.
There's a lot of big guys in the West Coast Conference, and of course, Holmgren and Drew Timmy at Gonzaga. But you have Toss, you have Masalski. Very, very solid post players.
BYU led the game 12-4, 4 minutes in. A foul as soon as they get across on Shabazz. Since then, the Dons are plus 27. Plus
wow.
27.
Wow. Well, that guy has a lot to do with it. Knocking in threes. He was conspicuously absent early, and then he became conspicuously present with his three-point shooting.
Lucas the wraparound, Lohner. Indecisive, then attacks and gets denied by Masalski.
Not getting anything in the paint because of the bigs.
Stefanini. Barcelo wants it. Quick load. Hits side backboard and a whistle.
Interior defense is the name of the game right here. Size advantage by the Dons. Notice the left hand block. The left hand is closer than your right hand to a right-handed player. You gain about 4 or 5 inches using that hand. And I think we've got to give a lot of credit really to the Dons. Their transition defense, getting back and identifying players early, has taken away the fast break weapon that BYU normally uses.
Both teams identified transition D before their first matchup and in advance of this matchup. as a critical key. Rare free throw miss for Barcelo, top 25 in the country at the line.
Nice weave.
Stefanini. Loner's got it. Dons thought he got hit. Barcelo screaming for it down the opposite side of the floor and a holding call. That'll be three on Stefanini.
He played at Columbia with Tappe. Both of the Ivy Leaguers switched coasts from the east to the west, and both enjoying terrific seasons here.
The BC transfer, Rishwain in. Loner giving the three, hits side iron. Masalski tried to box. Loner's got it. Tappe swats. Bouye. Rishwain opposite. Masalski, a two-hand jam. BYU in dire need of points, of flow, of some kind of momentum. Loner.
Tough shot. Left-handed hook from the center of the lane. Well, comebacks begin at this end of the floor. You got to defend. Can't keep letting them get easy shots. Effort required. Defense in the paint. This one was Tappe. He got plenty of it. And then at the offensive end, finishing in the paint with the bigs as well. This is a very well-balanced offensive team. You talk about Bouye and Shabazz on the outside, and you talk about Masalski especially, but also Tappe on the interior.
Well, Rishwain shook Knight. What a leave, and Tappe loses the dunk. Johnson against Bouye. Misses.
Whoa.
Shabazz rejected hard by a ticket.
Crowd is still into it despite being down 19.
Todd Golden told us he believed Masalski was the most under-recruited player in the country as a transfer out of San Diego.
Yeah, he thought that he wasn't going to get him from the portal. And his familiarity with the league was important, I think, in his decision to stay in the West Coast Conference.
Meeks up fake, cuts opposite Bouye. Shabazz hops into the paint, gets hit.
Nice sharing right there. That ball went side to side and inside and outside. Togetherness is a virtue, and they've got it. See how this ball moves. This is the end of it. Jump stop to avoid the charge and avoid the travel. This guy's solid fundamentally. Bouye is the more electric of the two guards, but together they're a great combination.
Foul to Barcelo, his third. Shabazz now leads San Francisco with 15 points. Barcelo against Shabazz gets screened off. Johnson inside to Tiki, hesitant shot. That's good.
He made a nice ball fake there. Able to gather his legs.
Shabazz. And Loner weak side.
See how quickly San Francisco's getting back. BYU is a fast break team, and they're not getting anything in transition.
A Tiki hook.
Two in a row.
He is the only Cougar besides Barcelo with more than 3 points.
Got eight now, I think.
Barcelo's got the ball, and he gets fouled.
Is there a run in the Cougars? There's some determination, I can tell you that. The jump hook is a thing of beauty. Every post player's got to have it. And right here, again. Get close in the paint. Use your size. He's the only real big on this team.
It's only the third turnover for the Dons against 12 assists. The foul to Masolsky, his third. He and Stefanini each with three. Loner in a tough spot. Passes out of it. Knight, the three ball. Air ball. Loner fouled. Meeks.
Well, BYU is showing some fight, that's for sure. This is a home game. 18,000 seats in this arena. There's probably 16,000 people here. And they're not going to give up, that's for sure.
Foul to Meeks, his second. It's already five on the Dons. Barcelo sees the double, finds Johnson up fake. Hopping to the rim. Tiki went up to help.
Todd Golden wants basket interference.
Bouye with no defender, and he misses a wide open layup. And he steals it from Barcelo. Tappe! And Bouye is in pain. He's on his backside, wincing dramatically. He hand signaled to the bench. He needs to come off the floor.
With his arm, his ankle gave way.
Circle this moment. 55-38 with 13:20 to go. Bouye leaves in visible pain. Knight. Off target, Rischwing. Koonin giving the three. Shabazz. Stefanini says slow it down.
Long threes, long misses equals long rebounds that guards can get.
And a travel on Stefanini. So the Dons' turnover total is doubled in just the last couple of minutes. And there's the tape work on the ankle of Bouye. Athletic trainer Casey Gonzalez furiously trying to get him ready to rejoin the fray. Lucas. Johnson up fake.
Size is really a factor in this game. A lot of guys on BYU dribble to the paint and then don't even take shots. It was 15 at halftime. It's 15 now. Dons without their leader. Look disjointed.
Foul on Loner, his third. 15-point affair. The BYU scouting report on Bouye, that he's a first-step man that can get anywhere on the floor he wants to, and they have him as a more accurate three-point shooter off the bounce than catch and shoot. He's now in the game with a bum wheel. And another turnover for the Dons. Barcelo, though, could not save it.
Bouye uses the dribble to create momentum. The defense then has to back up, and he shoots a lot of pull-up J's and step-back threes. He's not going to be able to do that with this ankle.
Up top, Rischwing. It's heel. Lucas has it.
When Tijon gets to the paint, he needs to shoot the basketball.
Knight's off scene. Two-hand flush. Is Bouye a defensive liability?
No doubt. No doubt about it. but him as a defensive liability when you have a big lead. And he's running the offense there smoother. No panic.
Booyah! Rainbow air ball.
Great D. A lot of time left. Half of the second half is still upon us.
Rich Wayne. Night and one.
Booyah defensively again. Smart by BYU. Whoever he's guarding. The fans aren't leaving, I'll tell you that.
Meeks ready to sub in and one for Knight to make it a 10-point affair. He does. It's a 13-2 run for BYU.
Taffé comes out. Meeks gives them better outside shooting. Not as much D in the paint. Wow.
Meeks up top. Dons haven't scored in 3.5 minutes. BYU hasn't had its single digits since late in the first half. Knight. Spencer Johnson's got it. Sharp dribble. Lucas wants the ball.
Guess who Boyer was guarding there? Boyer was guarding Johnson, and he got the rebound.
Foul to Shabazz is second. It's 7 fouls on the Dons with a lot of time left. So Lucas only 2 points in 21 minutes. 1-1.
Very unusual for him.
And another BYU miss. Rebound Cougars. Johnson off.
Wasowski was open deep. Nobody saw him. Todd Colden wants to run some clock here. Get a quality look. Shabazz wants it.
The Dons are 0 for 8 from deep this half.
Not enough scoring in the game right now for BYU.
And a foul on Shabazz.
Didn't need it. Lucas was down. And Shabazz tried to get the ball. He could have just stayed above him. Watch this. He falls down on his own. Right there, you don't need to reach for it. He's in a bad way. Lucas just missed his last trip. Wow. Nobody with 4. This is smart. That's the best possession they've had in the last 5 or 6 minutes. Wasowski is not a good free throw shooter. Two guys after him. one of the drawbacks of his game. Makes it anyway. Well, Barcelo back in, which is very, very important. Scoring required. Seneca did a nice job when he was in there. Scored twice on Bouye. Stefanini made a great play there. Missed free throw. They got possession back.
Shabazz. Masolsky's got it. Dons have missed 11 of their last 12. Bouye! Masolsky again. Stefanini.
First. It seemed like they were down here at this end for like 6 minutes. That's a killer. How about that for an answer? Bouye's been silent since the ankle.
Lucas to Atiki. George with the left hand. Masolsky fouled by Atiki.
BYU, Barcelo trying to pull his team in. They're there. One of the best in the nation.
Something that Mark Pope spoke about at great length, lauding not only their pure talent, but the amount of minutes they've logged together and how they complement one another.
Yeah. Vital, right? They want Tappe in the post.
Bouye. Shabazz out of the corner. Hits top backboard. Shot clock violation.
Great D again by the Cougars. Bouye is clearly not himself. But he's in there.
Loner misses. Traore. Foul.
Nice rebound by the 254-pound, 6'6" Traore. He is short for a post guy, but he's got a big heart and he's powerful close to the basket.
Foul to Tappe, his third. He is the fifth Don with three fouls. And it's also 9 on San Francisco, which means double bonus BYU the rest of the way. Their free throw woes continue.
Silly foul also.
It's only his first and the team's fifth. In some ways, that might be able to help them if they need a foul later and force foul shots.
Shabazz is the man in this game.
Tough shot, Stefanini.
Man, he is playing well. He has made a bunch of clutch shots with the shot clock down under 10. A lot of standing around here.
Barcelo lost handle, 10 to shoot. Loner taken away partially by Meeks. Bouye's got it. George and Johnson ready to sub in for BYU. Stefanini found the cutting. Tappe misses. Barcelo down the lane, rejected by Meeks. And some barking in the corner. Todd Golden raced all the way down the sideline. Todd Golden's going into this, trying to pull back. And plus, remember, Bouye injured that ankle that was heavily taped, and he's been standing on it, but not doing a whole lot.
He hasn't been himself since he's been back in the game, but he is helping, but not to his standard.
Corner three ball, air ball for George. One weak side by Bouye.
That is not a good shot after all that time. He's not a good three-point shooter, and he takes it after two passes.
32% outside shooter. George is 0 for 3 tonight. Don seemed willing to milk some time, and now George a foul with 8 seconds on the shot clock, and it brings about a 1-and-1 try for Stefanini, who's an 80% shooter.
You know, they get that juncture.
Free throw make. Up next, go coast to coast. The latest hoops news and insights as our experts break down all the action from beyond the court. Watch Inside College Basketball right here on CBS Sports Network. So two gifted points there. Tappe in, Meeks out.
Tappe gives him a little bit more shot blocking and rim protection than Meeks. Meeks gives him a little bit more outside shooting.
Nell is in left corner. He's a great outside shooter. Hot of late. Knight hopping into the lane. Goes right at Masalski and cannot finish.
Tappe immediately gets a rebound.
Stefanini. Traore all over Masalski in a foul.
Well, they're counting on Masalski to miss. His first personal. He made 1 out of 2 recently.
2 for 4 tonight. Sub 50% on the year, but in league action, he had been hitting about 2/3 of his free throws. Now, this is a tough place to hit free throws. The student section is about as dynamic as you'll find. They are right behind the basket.
That is making me dizzy just watching it.
So the hypnotic action does not impair Masalski. And BYU's running out of time. Nell indecisive. Now pops the three. Off target, Shabazz.
Golden is telling Masalski to get low. He doesn't want him to be the guy who gets fouled. See him pointing to the... Masalski's not sure what Golden wants right here. They say, get in the corner. We don't want to have you handle the ball and get fouled.
A 6-0 run for the Dons, mostly at the line.
They're a smart team.
Milking clock, 8 to shoot. Stefanini attacking Nell off the bounce. Help from Knight, falling away. Foul.
That
Well, he's got two, and it's double bonus rest of the way, both teams.
Seneca Knight gets off his feet on the pump fake.
And Todd Golden told us that he thought Stefanini was coming off his best overall floor game. Talked about how he's increased his comfortability, playing a lot of minutes. They put more on his shoulders than he had at Columbia.
He's a blend guy, right? I mean, with the two guards, they dominate the offense. And a guy like him is going to get some easy shots.
Knight draws a foul.
They are all over Barcelo. Whenever he comes off a screen, they are just doubling him and staying with him, daring them to get.
Tijon Lucas, who is BYU's second leading scorer, held to 2 points in 28 minutes tonight. One field goal make, one assist. Knight converts. BYU got it to eight. It was 58-50 at the 5:39 mark. That free throw snaps a 7-0 San Francisco run since.
They maintain their poise.
Another free throw miss. BYU 10 of 23 at the line.
Keep the ball moving here.
Oh, tic-tac-toe, tap a dunk.
That was a thing of beauty. Five guys touch the ball and a layup.
Emblematic of the night off Barcelo's foot for a BYU team that hasn't hit a bucket in 4.5 minutes. Shabazz, Tappe fouled.
Post to post passing, big to bigger, and an easy dunk. Vasalski and Tappe, nice 4-5 man combination.
Now keep in mind, San Francisco withheld the storm, and the Dons have done it in the second half without hitting a single three. They're 0 for 9 from deep this half for Todd Golden.
Interesting. They started off cold. In the middle, they were very hot. Both of the guards were 3 for 6 from three in the first half. And the second part of the first half.
San Francisco had said before the year, a stated goal was to try to go undefeated at home. Their first home loss came at the hands of BYU. They're trying to return the favor to a Cougar team 10-0 at home and go ahead and let them score, right?
Yeah.
Why absolutely. Stop the clock?
When you're behind, the clock is your enemy.
Shabazz picks it up. Stolen by Lucas. Spins into the paint and misses. And now a foul. And that'll be 5 on Spencer Johnson. Excuse me, it goes to Barcelo as his 4th. How those keys shape up?
Well, the guards produced. The guards did not produce for BYU. And the rim protection was not good. The offensive rebounding was. The bigs for San Francisco made a gigantic difference in this game.
BYU had never lost 3 in a row under Mark Pope. But this is window dressing. They're going to suffer their first 3-game slide since 2018. Dunked by Masalski. And fall for the first time at home this year. And by the way, they've got Gonzaga coming on Saturday.
Woo.
And Knight gets the bucket. Stefanini doubled, kicked high into the stands. Under a minute.
did not run. Yes.
Todd Golden, fresh off his 50th win as the head man at San Francisco, looking for one of his biggest wins in league play with the Dons. They bested Virginia in the regular season last year, but this has even more heft and import this deep in the year. Technical foul after a San Francisco called timeout, and then Shabazz has to be curled back by his coach.
Watch his arm. Well, he threw the basketball. That's probably what it was, and maybe said something at the same time. A little unnecessary at this point. Let's think about these two teams now. They've split the regular season. A two-point win.
Dons dominating in a building where the visitors rarely prevail. Barcelo at the line hits the front end of a technical free throw. Barcelo, an excellent free throw shooter.
I think this is a statement game for Todd Golden's group. They came in and had to win this game to even the series up, and they did it in great, great fashion. Very balanced scoring. Bigs dominated the interior. The guards played as they usually do. Bouye sprained an ankle but still played throughout, so we'll see how that affects him.
And a whistle from the end line of Randy McCall. Is it a clock issue here? What does this mean for the tournament resumes of these two teams?
Well, I think clearly for San Francisco, you know, Todd Golden was quoted after they won their game against Santa Clara. He said, this is our best win of the year. I think he's going to say that this one is the best win of the year.
And things are getting very chippy. That foul by Lucas. It's the front lip of the rim. Hits the back end. To Cole.
It hurts their chances, no doubt about that.
So now free throws for Richwayne. He misses on the front end. Hits the front lip of the rim. Hits the back end. .3 Stefanini. The Dons can dribble out the clock as they largely dominate in Provo. San Francisco hands BYU its first home loss of the year and does so in resounding fashion. A huge road win in a rout, 73-59. The final horn arrives. A big win for Todd Golden and the Dons. Their third ever victory in Provo.